Hello everyone, welcome back in mathematics class by Bhupinder Singh. Today we will discuss our last topic, division of integers. In division of integers, first we will discuss negative integer divided by a positive integer. Take one negative integer divided by one positive integer. When we have to divide negative integer by a positive integer, simple divide the whole number. Whole numbers are 15 and 3. Divide it. 3 1 the 3. 3 5 the 15. So our quotient is 5. Now one integer was negative. So put here a minus sign. So what we observe? When we divide a negative integer by a positive integer, we divide them as a whole number. We simply divide the whole numbers and put a minus sign before the quotient, and our answer is always negative integer. Related to this, try these are given. Simple divide the whole numbers and put a minus sign before the answers. When positive integer divided by negative integer, we will follow the same pattern. We just divide the whole number. Whole number are 15 divided by 3, that is 5. Now one integer was negative, so put minus sign before the answer. We conclude that when we divide a positive integer by a negative integer, first we divide them as a whole numbers and put a minus sign before the quotient. In both cases, negative integer divided by a positive integer and positive integer divided by a negative integer, our answer is same. A divided by minus b and minus a divided by b. In both cases, answer is same. Later to this, try these are given. Solve these, try these. Now next is when negative integer divided by negative integer. Take minus 6 divided by minus 2. For division, we will follow same pattern. Divide the whole numbers. 2 1 the 2, 2, 3 the 6. Now both the integers are negative, so minus sign cancel with minus sign. That time our answer is positive. So when negative integer divided by a negative integer, we just simple divide the whole numbers. Our answer is always positive. Here one condition is given that b should not be equals to 0. It means while dividing, denominator should not be equals to 0, because any number divided by 0 is non-defined term. Some tries are given. Negative integer divided by negative integer. Just divide the whole numbers. Answer is positive. Now we will discuss properties of division of integers. We have seen earlier that if any two integers are added, the result is an integer. If one integer is subtracted from any other integer, the result is an integer. Similarly, if any two integers are multiplied, the result is an integer. Now let us see, if an integer is divided by a non-zero integer, will the quotient be an integer? We know that minus 8 divided by 4 is equals to minus 2, and minus 16 divided by minus 4 is equals to 4. Here the quotient minus 2 and 4 in both the cases are integer. What? When an integer is divided by another non-zero integer, it is not always possible that the quotient is an integer. For example, minus 5 divided by 3 is not an integer. Hence, the collection of integer is not closed under division. The division of integer is not an integer in all the cases. So, integers are not closed under division. Now, we will check commutative property for the integer. What was the commutative property? It was when we change the order of the integers, then the answer is also same. Now check same property for the division. Take two integers, 8 and 4. First we divide 8 by 4. Then we change its order. We change its order, it's become 4 upon 8. Now check, is the answer is same in both cases? When we solve it, it's become 2. When we solve it, it's become 1 upon 2. So is 2 is equals to 1 upon 2? So division is not commutative for the integers. When we change the order of the division, the answer is also changed. Next is any integer divided by 0. As we discussed earlier, any number, not only integers, any whole number, natural number, integers, when it divided by 0, it is a not defined term. But when 0 is divided by any number, that time our answer is 0. Now next is when we divide integers by 1. When we divide any integer by 1, the answer is the integer itself. Any integer divided by 1 gives the same integer. So a divided by 1 is equals to a. On same page, try these are given. First is 1 divided by a is equals to 1. Now check it. Take any value of a. Let's say is a 2. So 1 divided by 2, that is equals to 1 upon 2. Is 1 upon 2 is equals to 1? No. So it means it is not true. Second part. A divided by minus 1. Take any value of a. Take again. A value is 2. It is divided by minus 1. Divided by minus 1. As we discuss in the properties, it is equals to minus 2. That is equals to minus a. So it is true. Now we will discuss associative property for the division of integers. What is the associative property? It is a property which shows when we change the groups, answer is same. Now check it for the division of the integers. Here we are taken the group of minus 16 divided by 4. Here we are taken the group of 4 divided by minus 2. When we solve this side, our answer is 2. When we solve this side, our answer is 8. It means division is not associative for the integers. Example number 6. In a test, plus 5 marks for a correct answer and minus 2 marks for a incorrect answer. A part. Radhika answered all the questions. Number of questions are not given, but she answered all the question and her final score is 30 and she got 10 correct answer, and correct answers are given. What we have to find? We have to find the number of incorrect answers attempted by Radhika. For Radhika, two things are given. First is the total score is given, that is 30. Second is correct answers are given, that is 10. For a one correct answer, marks are 5, total correct answers are 10, for a 10 correct answer marks are 50. Now her total marks are given 30, correct marks are 50, total score is 30. Now first we find the marks for the incorrect answer, that is the total marks 30 minus marks for a correct answer. Subtract it, so incorrect marks are minus 20. For one incorrect answer, minus 2 marks. Then for a minus 20 marks, how many answers are incorrect? For it, we just divide incorrect marks by the marks for one incorrect answer. When we divide it, answer is 10. So incorrect answer attempt by Radhika are 10. Secondly, Jaya answered all the questions. Same, she answered all the questions and score minus 12 marks and he got 4 correct answer. So marks of Jaya are minus 12 and his 4 answers are correct. So first we find the marks for the 4 correct answer. For, For one correct answer, 5 marks. For four correct answer, 5 into 4, that is equals to 20. So 20 marks for the correct answers, and total score is minus 12. Now we find the marks for an incorrect answer, that is total score minus marks for correct answer. Total score minus marks for a correct answer. So incorrect marks are minus 32. For one incorrect answer, marks are 2. Now find the total number of incorrect answer. Total incorrect marks divided by marks for one incorrect answer. Divide 32 divided by 2 is 16 incorrect answers. Example number 7. A shopkeeper earns a profit of rupees 1 by selling one pen. If we sell one pen, then a profit. Profit we will show with a plus sign. Then there is a profit of rupees 1. It's a 1 rupees. And incur a loss of 40 paisa. Now paisa is given per pencil. If we sell one pencil, then there is a loss. Loss means minus 40 paisa. So if he sells one pen, then there is a profit of rupees 1. If he sells one pencil, then there is a loss of 40 paisa. Don't be confused. Pen profit is in rupees and loss is in paisa. Now question is given, first part. In a particular month, she incurs a loss of rupees 5. She sold some pencils and some pens. At last, she incurs a loss of rupees 5. Underline this formula, that is of total loss. Total loss is equals to total profit plus loss. Find the sum of the profit and loss, that is equals to total loss or total profit. Now in a particular month, she incurs total loss of 5. Total loss is given, that is rupees 5. In this period, she sold 45 pens. Total pens she sold, that are 45. You have to find the number of pencils. She sold 45 pens. From one pen, there is a profit of rupees 1. Profit earned by one pen is rupees 1. She sold 45 pens. So profit of 45 pens is rupees 1 multiply 45. That is equals to rupees 45. So profit of that month is rupees 45. Overall loss of rupees 5. So loss is given, so total loss is in negative, minus rupees 5. Now we already discussed the formula of total loss or profit, that is our profit earned plus loss. Now profit earned is given, that is rupees plus 45. So put its value, 45 plus loss is given, so here loss is equals to total loss. Total loss is given, that is minus 5, so is equals to minus 5. Now 45 is plus this side it's become minus, so loss is minus 5 minus 45, that is minus 50. So total loss of that month is minus 50 rupees. Now what we have to find? We have to find the number of pencils. First we find the loss from that pencils. Loss of pencil is given in paisa, but here loss is in rupees. So first we convert this loss into in paisa. 1 rupees there are 100 paisa. So in 50 rupees multiplied with 100, that is minus 5000
paise.
Minus sign shows the loss. Now loss from a one pencil is 40. Now we have to find the total number of pencils. So total loss, that is 5000 divided by the loss from a one pencil. So minus 5000 divided by minus 40. Divide it. After division, we will get 125 pencils. Now B part, in the next month, she earns neither profit nor loss. And she sold 70 pens. So total profit plus loss is equals to 0. Total sold pens are given 70. When there is a no loss and no profit, it means profit earned is equals to loss. So first we find the profit by 70 pens. From a 1 pen, there is a profit of 1 rupees. From a 70 pens, there is a profit of rupees 70. If profit is rupees 70, both are same profit and loss, it means loss is also of rupees 70 rupees. Now loss of pencils are given in paisa, so we will convert this 70 rupees into paisa. We will multiply it with by 100, so there is a loss of 7000. Here minus sign shows the loss. Now we have to find the number of pencils. This loss divided by the loss by one pencil. So 7000 divided by minus 40. Minus sign cancel with minus sign. Number of pencils are 175. Now exercise 1.4. First question is evaluate. We have to find the division of these parts. These divisions are, we already discussed in the properties of the division. Solve up these parts by own. Second question, verify that A divided by B plus C is not equals to A divided by B plus A divided by C. This is the distributive property. We have to show that division is not distributive under addition. A, B, C values are given. Put these values on the left hand side, find its value. Put these values on the right hand side, find its value. After that, you can see left hand side is not equals to right hand side. It means division of the integer is not distributive under the addition. Next question. Fill the blanks. Blanks you have to fill. 369 divided by which number? So the answer is 369. When we divide by 1. 75 becomes minus 1. Minus 75 becomes minus 1. So we will divide it by a same number. In same way, solve these blanks. Question number 4. Write 5 pairs of the integers. Pair we have to find such that A divided by B is equals to minus 3. You have to find the pairs whose division is minus 3. One pair is given 6 divided by minus 2. That is equals to minus 3. Find more 5 pairs. Take one pair minus 6 divided by 2. When we divide it, answer is minus 3. Second pair is 12 divided by minus 4. When we divide it, answer is minus 3. Then minus 12 divided by 4, that is also minus 3. Like this way, we can take a number of pairs. Fifth question. The temperature at 12 noon was 10 degrees Celsius above 0. Above 0, it means temperature is plus 10 degrees Celsius. It decreased. Decrease means minus sign. At the rate of 2 degrees Celsius per hour. In 1 hour, it is decreased by 2 degrees Celsius. At what time would the temperature be 8 degrees Celsius below 0? 8 degrees Celsius below 0 means the temperature is minus 8 degrees Celsius. Now, how we will find it? Earlier temperature is 10 degrees Celsius. And we have to find the time when the temperature is 8 degree Celsius. Below 0 means minus 8 degree Celsius. And its decrease rate is 2 degree Celsius. Now, at 12 o'clock, it is at 10 degree Celsius. Then it is decreased 2 degree Celsius per hour. So, after 1 hour means at 1. It is decreased by 2 degree Celsius, so that is 10 minus 2, so it is 8 degree Celsius. Then again it is decreasing in the order of 2 degree Celsius per hour. Then at 2, it is 8 minus 2, 6 degree Celsius. Then at 3 o'clock, it is 6 minus 2, 4 degree Celsius. Then at 4, it is 4 minus 2, that is 2 degree Celsius. At 5, it is 2 degree Celsius minus 2 degree Celsius, 0 degree Celsius. Then at 6, it is 0 degree Celsius minus 2, that is minus 2 degree Celsius. At 7 o'clock, minus 2 degree Celsius minus 2 degree Celsius, minus 4 degree Celsius. At 8, minus 4 degree Celsius minus 2 degree Celsius, minus 6 degree Celsius. Then at 9, minus 6 degree Celsius minus 2 degree, that is minus 8 degree Celsius. Here is also minus. So when the temperature is minus 8 degree Celsius at 9 o'clock. So our answer is 8 degree Celsius below 0 is at 9 o'clock. Its B part is, what would be the temperature at midnight? At noon, it is at 10 degree Celsius above 0. 10 degree Celsius above 0 means positive. And it is decreased 2 degree Celsius per 1 hour. From noon to midnight, there are the 12 hours. In 1 hour, it is decreased by minus 2 degree Celsius. In 12 hours, it is decreased by minus 2 into 12, that is minus 24 degree Celsius. Earlier temperature was 10 degree Celsius. And it is decreased minus 24 degree Celsius. Now find the total temperature after 12 hour. Find their sum. 10 minus 24, that is minus 14 degree Celsius. So after 12 hour at the midnight, temperature is minus 14 degree Celsius. Question number 6. In a test, plus 3 marks for a correct answer, minus 2 marks for an incorrect answer, and 0 marks for a non-attempting. This question we already discussed in the example. Solve this question by its own. Question number 7. An elevator descends into a mine at the rate of 6 meters per minute. So in 1 minute, it covers a distance of 6 meters. If the descents start from 10 meter above the ground, take this as the ground level. It starts from 10 meter above, so it starts from 10 meter above the ground. How long will it take to reach minus 350? Minus 350, so from a ground level, it moves downwards the distance of 350. Meter. Here minus sign shows it moves downside. It starts from a 10 meter and it has to move till 350. So what is the distance covered by this elevator? That is the sum of these two distances. So first find the distance, that is the 10 meter plus 350 meter, that is the 360 meter. So distance covered by elevator is 360 meter. Now how long it will take? We have to find the time. In 1 minute, it covers a distance of 6 meter. We have to find the total time. So we will divide 360 total distance by a distance covered in 1 minute. Meter cancel with meter. 6 1 the 6. 6 60 the 36. So it is a 60. Now rate is given in minutes. So answer is also in minute. It is a 60 minute. It will take 60 minute to reach to minus 350. Or in hours, you can write it 1 hour. Now our chapter is completed. If you face any problem in this chapter, then share your queries in the comment section below. Thank you. Have a nice day.